Hello viewers, my name is Florence Minor. We're welcoming you to yet another time of Celebrate Your Moment to enjoy this Sunday evening. As I've always said, Sundays I like to bring it late afternoon or in the evening so that we can be able to share in case you did not go to the house of God today, which I would encourage you to go next time because we have a whole week that God has given us. He has given us the strength, He has given us the job, He has given us the favor. You can imagine the life we have, the breath we have, is God has just given us by the grace. You know, we don't even deserve it because, no, there are people who right now who are sick who cannot walk. Others have died. You have not given God anything so that you can be alive. So it's good to appreciate what He has done for you by going to the house of God. The title of my message tonight will be, Temptations Are Sure to Come. Because I know the enemy can always try to trap us and make us think like we are the only one who are suffering. But I want to tell you, even Jesus Christ Himself was tempted. In our church, we are covering a series about prayer. And today we had a chance of the junior high pastor preaching, Pastor George. Also, it was such a blessing, even as you are a mentor to my son, seeing you preaching such a wonderful message. And he was preaching on the part of the Lord's Prayer that says from Matthew 6, deliver us from evil. When our Lord Jesus Christ was tempted, after he had fasted for 40 days, he was hungry. So the enemy will always bring those things he knows. They are very basic and they are real. You need them. When he told, when the devil told Jesus, if you are the Son of God, you can make these stones to be bread. Because he knew Jesus was hungry, but Jesus said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone. When you are tempted, what do? You need the word of God. How do you get the word of God? You have to make time. You have to be intentional to read this word of God. At the time of the temptation, you may not have the Bible with you, but you need to hide it in your heart. Our hearts are like the bank account that we put money. And at the time of need, you go and withdraw. When we bank this word, when we read it day in, day out, whether you are in problem or not, the Spirit of God will remind you when you need it at the time of temptation. When you are sick, God will remind you that word you have read, that by His stripes you have been healed. When you are ornery, the Spirit of God will remind you the word you might have learned, that He is more than a thousand friend to you. So tonight, I believe that you'll desire to have the word of God in your life. We also overcome the temptation by worship and praise. We can also overcome the word of God by being generous, by serving God. So may the Lord help you. Let us pray. Father in heaven, help us to know that temptations are sure to come, but how we handle them is what matters and give us a victory. Help us, oh God. And for those who have not accepted you as the Lord and Savior, may they desire to have you, and so that they can be new creatures, even as your word says, in Jesus' name. May the Lord bless you. Let us continue to share this word so that we can encourage one another. Amen. Thank you.